So I just got this release in today, this whippersnapper. I was shooting the Saturday night special. And this, my buddy actually had one of these and I shot it and really like it. Really just seems to fit me perfect. So I think we're gonna switch over to this, but I gotta make sure my point of impact is on. Didn't seem to be, appeared to be so. How about a little Muley Madness? Bottom of the 10, maybe? A little breezy today. Perfect conditions for hunting. I'm fired up. So in case you didn't hear, we're going after the Wolverine buck tonight. We have perfect conditions. So I'm just firing a few rounds, make sure the bow's on, make sure I'm ready. Yodi, 10. Muley, 10. Last one, last but not least, right here. And this was shooting a broadhead. And that was pretty well where I was aiming. I don't like they got the heart a little far back on these. So I just kind of come up the leg. Black Widow. And that was with the Wasp broadhead there. Always important to make sure your broadheads hit the same as your field points. But I think I'm ready to go. It's almost time to head to the stand. A couple more shots and we're heading out.
Realtree's Midwest Whitetail is brought to you by RK Tractors, Ozonix, Redneck Blinds, Wasp Archery, Spot Hog Releases, RTP Outdoors, America's Best Bowstrings, Hoyman Tree Saws, and Realtree.
We are headed to hunt the Wolverine buck. Of the bucks we have to go after, he is the most likely, I think, we could see him. He's been pretty consistent in the area we're headed to. If he's not dead from EHD, that's the question mark. Fortunately, we've been finding a few. Yeah, we're having a little bout with EHD. We found a few dead and we're just walking in to hunt that Wolverine buck. We can smell one dead right here somewhere. Might look around just a second, see if we can find it so we're not wasting our time if perhaps it's the Wolverine buck. I'm not gonna look too long, but might just peek around here. Us a little bit to get set up. We're on that Wolverine buck. We've already got a couple of bucks in the field down there. It's the third one we've seen already, and it's only, I don't know, 4:30 or something. That Wolverine buck has been using this trail I mowed right here. I've got a camera set up on that scrape, and he keeps walking out right here, so conditions are perfect tonight. We've got this cold front came through. Beautiful, like 60 degrees, went from like 85 down to 60 for high. Northwest wind, so I feel like they should move. Well, they already are moving, but I think Wolverine will move before dark tonight, so we'll sit in here, keep our fingers crossed. Pretty well covered up with deer since we got in the stand. Nothing mature though. I think we've seen 3 bucks and like 9 or 10 does. But the Wolverine buck so far is a no-show. It's like 6:20, so we're just getting into prime time. I'm still hopeful. We'll sit in here and see what happens. Some anxious moments right here. Got that Wolverine buck right here and behind us. I just hit him with a grunt. He heard it. He's got a cross. across a ravine right there. We'll see if he comes this way. It looked like he was kind of angling off to the east, but we'll see. Listen to those old Canadian honkers. Familiar sound every fall, I love it. Man, what an awesome sit. We got to see our target buck. I feel like he's still right around here somewhere. He's just in that thick cover. Can't get much closer than that. He was over there about 60, maybe 70 yards. He still might pop out. We got about 10 minutes left, but if anything happens, we'll show you. Otherwise, we'll see you tomorrow.